One bot, many clients, zero data leakage. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to build a multi-tenant chatbot, a single bot that serves multiple businesses while isolating each tenant's data. It's perfect for reusing one template across different clients like hotels and resorts without having to spin up a dozen different chatbots. Let's build it. So the problem statement is as follows. We have these two separate businesses, both of which are restaurants, but they're reasonably different. You know, one of them is this chill, fun vibes pizza truck. The other one is this haute cuisine, fine dining Nordic restaurant. They have reasonably different personalities. They have different ways of conveying information to the customer, but in either case, we want to be able to do pretty much the same operations. Ask questions about the restaurant, possibly book reservations. So the question that we're diving into today is trying to figure out how do we build a single chatbot, deploy a single chatbot that can work for both of these restaurants in such a way that the data doesn't get confused between the two restaurants. So customers of Aurora are only getting information and only executing operations that are consistent with Aurora, and customers for Lola, same thing. And even more importantly, data doesn't get leaked. So here we are in the Botpress studio, and I'm going to show you how we set up the basic infrastructure to be able to dispatch between different clients in the same bot. So the way that we're going to switch between the bots is using different knowledge bases, one dedicated knowledge base for each bot. So we're going to do one for Aurora and one for Lola's. Now the big question, how do we index the knowledge bases? What we do is we add a table that indexes the knowledge base based on the tenant, tenant to KB. That means when we get an incoming event, we determine which tenant it is, and the tenant is basically the restaurant, Aurora or Lola. We draw all the information for that tenant, including the knowledge base and other information, which we'll get to in a second. So column tenant ID and the ID of the tenant. Pretty self-explanatory. We'll make it nullable for now just because adding the information is easier. And this could be arbitrary. You could give it like a specific name, but if you want to be a little more secure, you could come up with like a hashed ID. We're not going to worry about that for now. So edit row, we'll call it Aurora tenant. We'll add a record. Okay, Lola's tenant. Those are our tenant IDs. And now we want to be able to index the knowledge base. How do we do that? We get the knowledge base ID. Now, what is the knowledge base ID? You go to the knowledge base, Aurora, copy the ID right there. Now back to the table, go to the KB ID column, and we paste it in. And this is what it should look like, KB dash, and then some ID string. We'll do the same thing for Aurora, I mean for Lola's. Cool, those are our knowledge bases. Now, we have to be able to index the knowledge base and the specific knowledge base, only the one that we have access to in the case of each flow, which means for every conversation, there's only one KB ID available. Of course, in the event that a single tenant has multiple KBs available to them, you could make this into an array. We're not gonna do that for now. So we have a KB ID. In the search knowledge base in the main autonomous node, you have the option to insert a dynamic value. And in this case, we're gonna do conversation.KB ID dynamically. This has changed to dynamic. In general, everything should work now, except for we don't have bot infrastructure or a way of checking the tenant ID or instructions. So we'll have to do that now. Now is the part where we write the prompt and abstract it in such a way that it has hard-coded all of the information that's common to all the tenants, but it abstracts the information that's specific to each tenant. I'll show you what I mean in this section. So I have this instruction written. You probably could have guessed this, but it was written by ChatGPT. Again, LLMs write instructions for LLMs. Now, it doesn't have specific stuff like opening hours because that has to be determined by the tenant. But what it does have is stuff like provide informal answers only based on the knowledge base, FAQs, operations. It gives an overview of the way the bot should be interacting with customers. So we see here, there's a lot of stuff abstracted. This is going a little bit overboard. I don't think you have to point out this many details necessarily, but I thought that this was an extreme example that could illustrate the extremities of what you could pull off with a setup like this. Notice that all of these are in the conversation.restaurant config object. These are in the conversational namespace because I want them to be accessible throughout the conversation. What you have to do once you come up with your prompt and come up with all the different variables is actually create those variables. So we're going to create the conversation restaurant config variable, and we're going to create a new schema for this. This one is going to be pretty long. This just has all the information for each of the variables with a description and the data types. So we're going to add restaurant config in the conversation namespace. And the schema it's going to have is this schema over here with all the information exhaustively described. I'm gonna call this type a restaurant config schema. Cool. Config for the system prompt. Cool. So we've added that variable. Now the information that's stored in the conversation.restaurant config is all going to be accessible in the system prompt. Now we have all of these fields in the restaurant config, but that information doesn't exist yet. So what we have to do is store in our knowledge base all of these fields, you know, the voice tone, voice energy, voice sentence style, everything like that. How I'm choosing to do this right now is just creating fields for that inside of our tenant to KB table. So it has access to the knowledge base, which stores information, but the table itself can also store information instead of having to access the specific knowledge base. So here I have this table already made and it has all the information for each tenant. So Aurora tenant and Lola's tenant. So what we're gonna do is get rid of this table for the time being and upload that save table we have with all the information. Very cool. We have all the information here now that we're going to need for the system prompt. The big question is now, how do we access the information for the system prompt? We have all the variables set up in the prompt. We also have a schema and a variable to hold that information that can be passed to the prompt, but we don't have a way of getting that data from the table into the conversation variable so it can then be passed to the system prompt. So let's have a look at how to do that now. We want to publish our bot because that'll give us the information that we need to embed it via web chat. So share, configure. Now this is the web chat code. This is the simplest way to embed a bot, in my opinion. This is the page for the mock website for Aurora. We'll deal with the other one later. Now at the end of the head tag, we want to add this new script tag. This is kind of a simple initialization JavaScript file. This has information like a bot ID and a client ID, which is specific to our bot, but the rest of the information is stuff that we can modify and we will be doing that. So we paste that information into a new JavaScript file. Now we can get rid of this tag because this is in the JavaScript file. And we're going to, instead of looking at index, we're going to look at aurora.js. Aurora.js is here. Now we have our client ID, we have our bot ID set up. What we want to be able to do is pass our tenant ID from our tenant's website to the bot. So we pass Aurora tenant ID. Now, in this case, Aurora's tenant ID is Aurora tenant. Cool, let's have a look, make sure it's actually firing up on the website. It's there, it's blue because we reset it, it's set up. Now what we want to be able to do is access that tenant ID that was sent over here in the user key. We're gonna add a get user data card, get user data, just like that. Now we hook up our start node to it. What this get user data card does is accesses the information that is in the user key over here. The user ID in this case doesn't really matter because the user will change from session to session and that doesn't have anything to do with the conversation, the bot, or the tenants, most importantly. So we just access it dynamically, done. Now we wanna store that information in a variable so we can access it later. It has to be a workflow variable. So I'm gonna create user data as a variable and as a sanity check, I'm just going to send back to the user to see how it works, the information in that variable. So we're gonna publish it. We're gonna take it for a whirl. Published, cool. Let's have a look-see. Hello. Okay, and it's shown us the user data. There's embedded this key called user data, and then it has the tenant ID, Aurora tenant, which is what we want. Cool. Now we want to be able to take that data and index the correct record inside the tenant to knowledge base table. This one over here. We see that this row over here has the tenant baked in, and it also has the rest of the information that we're looking for. So we add an execute code card to look through the table. So what we want to do is grab the tenant ID from that object. So we access the user data variable and the user data key within that variable. And now we have to grab the proper config. So we look at the tenant to knowledge base table and we search through the records. Now, how I'm gonna do that here is the filter function and I will say tenant ID, which means the tenant ID column in the table is equal to the tenant ID variable. Now we have all this information in the table. I want to leave the KB ID and the ID behind. I don't wanna bind those to the restaurant config variable. I maybe don't want the system prompt looking at IDs that the user doesn't have to see and these are just indexes and they're maybe a little bit sensitive. So I'm pulling them out in the destructuring of the object. This here config returns an array. Now the KB ID we bind to this newly destructured object K. Now we have the restaurant config. We're gonna bind it to the conversation variable. Dun, dun, dun. Otherwise we'll throw an error. Cool. And then all we do is head over to the autonomous node. Because I uploaded a file to fill out the information to the tenant to KB table, I need to update the values in that table with the correct knowledge base. So I did the other one before. Just gonna do this one right now. All right, now I would like to publish the bot and see if it works end to end for a single one of the tenants, which means if we're passing the right tenant ID, it's fetching the information from the restaurant config and the autonomous node is properly accessing the different variables. Let's see how it works. Okay, so it knows it's Aurora, which is a really good start. Now, what I did for the sake of this tutorial was separated the information out into stuff that's in the table for the prompt and knowledge base information so that I can show you how to work with a knowledge base in this format. We don't have information yet in that knowledge base, so let's add that. The information I'm gonna add here is the stuff that's a little bit more lengthy and verbose that you wouldn't wanna put in the system prompts. So stuff like the hours, save, let's publish that again, and let's see if we can access that information in the knowledge base. What are your opening hours? Cool, super awesome. Now what I wanna do is hook up the information from the other knowledge base and test to see if we can switch between the tenants. So we have all this rich text, done. Now, how do we get this set up? Here we have Lolo's pizza truck. I already have the code embedded. We wanna embed the exact same bot ID and client ID. Let's do that here, but we use a different tenant ID. In this case, Lola's. Everything should be rock solid. Let's test it to see if it adopts the personality of the other tenant we're gonna be using, Lola's, namely. Good sign that it changed because it's blue. Let's give her a spin, hello. And it has a different personality. It's talking about a different restaurant. Do you do reservations? No reservations, no pre-orders. Okay, it's getting it right. So that worked. We're switching between tenants and we're accessing the exact same bot ID, same client ID, and we're getting the different personalities with access to different knowledge bases. This is great. You can extend this to be able to do stuff like reservations. I was just showing you a bare bones structure, a version of this that switches between the different knowledge bases. Let's say that you are deployed with a different integration. For example, WhatsApp. The question becomes, how do you access the different data through WhatsApp that generally doesn't give you the option to send the tenant ID via user data. I'm gonna show you how to do that right now. Let's install the WhatsApp integration. So now we're going to send back to the user just the event because I wanna show you what it looks like to be able to detect incoming events from WhatsApp as opposed to from Webchat. Publish, 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 fire up the integration. So this is what the event looks like for WhatsApp. When the bot receives a WhatsApp event, it will have this key integration and the value will be WhatsApp. In the event that it comes through Webchat, the value of that will be WebChat. So it's a really simple way to check whether the event is coming from WhatsApp or WebChat. Another important point here is that for each WhatsApp deployment on a different device or a different number, you will get a WhatsApp phone number ID. So you have a WhatsApp phone number ID associated with the phone number to which your bot is deployed, or one for each tenant. So in the same way that you can send a tenant ID to validate each tenant with respect to the bot, you can do the same thing for WhatsApp with a bot phone number ID. So it's WhatsApp colon bot phone number ID. Here in our table, I already added the key WhatsApp bot phone number ID. And for Aurora's, we're just gonna put in, for the time being, the value you just saw. Now this bot is going to know, okay, we're looking at Aurora. Now, I'm not necessarily gonna do this in the cleanest way ever, but we're gonna create some code to be able to detect which integration the conversation's coming from. Standard node. So we're gonna say in the event.integration equals WebChat. Cool, so in the event that the integration is WebChat, or frankly, WhatsApp, we're gonna go to the WhatsApp flow. Otherwise, we're gonna default to the WebChat flow. That's just how I'm gonna do it for now. Obviously, you'd want it to be a little bit more sophisticated in the event that you have, I don't know, multiple different channels. Now, if it's coming from WhatsApp, we want to fetch the bot phone number ID from the event that we saw before. Event tags.conversation, bot phone number ID. And then we do all the same operations that we did in the other execute code card. We index that in the table and then we grab the rest of the information from the table, including the knowledge base ID or the KB ID. We bind the KB ID in our conversation namespace and then we pass that to the autonomous node, which means we now have to hook this up to the autonomous node. And we should, in theory, have everything we need. Let's give her a whirl, see what happens. All right, and it knows it's Aurora, so everything works. One little note on security. In this implementation, we're passing our tenant IDs through the front end with basically no encryption. You'd ideally want to set up some infrastructure where the tenant ID is passed along the back end and then authenticated using session tokens. This delves into solution engineering, and that's kind of a topic for another video. So that's how you build and deploy a single chatbot that can serve multiple tenants. If you have any questions, throw them down below in the comments. And if you'd like to get involved with the community, you can join our Discord. I put the link down below. For more examples of AI agent templates, you can check out this video where we showcase the kitchen sink bot, an all-purpose template that can be adapted for different clients. See you next time. Ciao.